some of these powers. So here you have to notice that this choice A, choice D, and choice E have the same unit digits, but different tens digit. The unit digits are the last ones, and the tens digits are these ones. Now, note that choice B and choice C have the same unit digits, but different ten digits. Therefore, we need to find what are the units digit and the tens digit of the sum of these powers. We're going to do the following. Let's start with 47. So units digit is 9, because 7 times 7 is 49. Here we have 4, then we have 4 times 7, 28, plus 4, 32. Here 4 times 7 is 28. So unit digits, 10 digits. Now let's do the same with 48. Units digit 4, 6. Now 4 and 8 is 32 plus 6, 38. And 4 times 8 is 32. So here again, units digit 4, tens digit 0, same way 49. So here we have 81, 8 here, 4 times 9 is 36 plus 8 is 44 here, 6. So again, 1 and 0. Now, 50 squared, yeah, that's a number that can be rearranged like this. This is 50 times 50, or we can do the following. This is 5 times 10 times 5 times 10, so we have 25 times 100. So 50 squared is 2500. So units digit and tens digit 00. So now let's go ahead with 51. So this one is 1, 5, and 5, so 0, 1, and 52. So here we have 4, 10, and 10 again, so 0 and 4. And finally, we have to do it with 53. I will do it here. For 53, we have 9 and 15. Again, 15, 0, 9. So once we have all the tens and units digit of each of the powers, we need to find the sum of all of them. So we have 0, 9, 0, 4, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 4, and 0, 9. The sum is the following. So here we have 9 and 1, 10. 9 and 1, another 10, so 20. And 20 plus 4, 24 plus 4, 28. So here we have 28. 2 here, 0, 0, 0, 0, and 2, 28. So we know that the tens digit of the sum of all of these powers is 2, and the units digit is 8. Therefore, choice C is correct.